Okay, we'll square off the end. Now we'll come around and hollow out the inside of the acorn. We'll go to the scraper. And that's pretty nice inside now. Now we'll come around and use the Berdan to put our pin in. Get it about there. We'll get our depth figured out, like we do on a box. We'll come down to there. Now we're going to use our detail gouge. And we can pin this down up here. Kind of come down and start shaping our nut. And an acorn usually kind of goes in and then has just a little tip out here at the end. Alright, we can do a little bit of sanding on that. And as you notice, we don't have this top part, we don't really have super nice yet, but we're going to jam chuck that and finish that off. Now I like to use the skew to go in and cut it off, and in the process I'm trying to shape that tip a little bit more, but as I get in there we go, and see, I'm not real good, but we're going to fix that here in a minute. Okay, now we need to go over to our walnut to make the cap out of. Alright, we've got our walnut in. The first thing is, we'll face it off. And then we're going to come in with our skew and we're going to try to mark our diameter. Okay, I've got an idea now of where it goes. We'll come around, hollow out that inside. And we can go back to our scraper. And see, we can't come out. We need to leave a little bit here because now we're going to come back in with our Berdan and try to cut that to fit. And still just a little bit. And we need this to be a good tight fit. Okay, once we get it to kind of set, we take our Alright, we've almost got it in there. Then I'm making cake. And go ahead and get it tightened in there. Now we can true up that in. Real light cuts because we're just friction fit in there. We're getting a lot of torque out here on the end. Sandpaper. Straighten up the bottom of that. Now I like to go in and cut just a little bit of a bevel on the top of that nut. And we can pull it out and see where I've just put just a little bit of a bevel just right here. And now it's still fitting a little tight, so we want to go in and just clean out the inside so that our lid fits. Okay. Got that cleaned out. Now here I'm going to go to the large parting tool because I need to make a plate for that skin. Alright, as you can see there, we went down and made a pretty good gap in there. Now we'll take our detail out. We're going to roll the front over pretty much so we don't have a lot of rim there. And then we'll start rolling to the back. Now, this is where we're going to slow the lathe down and come back, and we're going to come in with our detailer, and we're going to start out here, and we're going to come in, and then we're going to turn our detailer this way and start back here. Alright, and as what we've done there, see, we've put our texture up to about here, so we've had it textured from there to there. Alright, now we can come in, bring our lathe speed back up, cut that lid off, and now we need to come back in with our burn-in, and we need to fit that lid. Okay, we can take our mallet and put that lid on there, reset the tool rest, and then I like just using the skew, come in with our skew, on there, we'll round the end a little bit. Now we can come in with our detail gouge and kind of round this out. And we're going to texture this. We don't need to worry quite so much about how well we detail that out. Okay, back down to about 400. Come back in with our tool, and we'll start in here. Now we'll turn our tool the other direction. Back up there. Now we're not real good out here on the end. That's just a matter of getting the tool down in there a little bit better. And there we've got our texture. So we pop that off. As you can see, we've got it on there good and tight. And our other piece. And there's our acorn.